On Friday, June the 23rd, we hosted session number 49 of Davos Experience in Tokyo.
We're just about to start via the session number 49 of Davos Experience in Tokyo. And together with me is...
Ria, yes, you come from Human Rights Watch Tokyo office.
And today we'll be talking about refugees, human rights violations and things like that, which is a global agenda, but a little bit different from what we have been discussing. And tell us a little bit about Human Rights Watch activities throughout the world and in Japan.
Sure, thank you. So Human Rights Watch, we were founded about 40 years ago, and we cover 90 different countries around the world. Mm-hmm. We investigate different kinds of human rights abuses on the ground, and we share the information, and then we make the change. So we bring the information to policymakers and then stop those violations.
I see. That's going to be quite a dangerous job, isn't it, to do the research and investigate?
Yes, it is. And the safety is our most, the biggest concern for us. And we make sure that the victims that we hear stories from are protected.
I see. What about, I think human rights violations and human rights is kind of a distant topic in Japan, but is it?
It is still, but I think it should be more close to our hearts, because in this globalized world, nothing could happen to us at any time.
Right.
So we hope that through our activities, we want to bring global issues closer to Japanese people's hearts.
I see. So you'll be talking about those things today, and we're very much looking forward to it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Nelly. A little bit on the serious side among the global agenda. And together with me is...
Yasser Jamal, Dean. I'm from Syria, 25 years old. Yeah, I'm going to try to make a little bit the image of the Syrian crisis clear as I can.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, so.
Have you had a lot of opportunities to explain what it's like in Syria to the Japanese community? And
Yes, actually, socially, I'm so active around Tokyo universities.
Mm-hmm.
Like just a few days ago, I did a presentation for Hitotsubashi University, and the one before for Rikyo University, Todai Mae. I'm gonna have like a new one on July 5th.
I see.
So yeah, I do a lot of presentation, and I've done more than 25 presentations so far. So I change a lot of people's mind about the Syrian crisis.
I see.
So yeah, I just like want to make everything clear about Syria, because there's many misunderstanding and people mix and misconcepts. There's a lot of misconceptions about many things, it's happening in Syria, and people, like especially in Japan, like they don't know anything about it. So
right.
I'll always do my best to make the image of the Syrian crisis clear.
Great. So we're very much looking forward to hearing a lot about Syria from you.
I hope I have kind of this. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, we have 15 minutes or 10 minutes here. Usually my presentation takes like 1 hour to explain everything in details, but I'll try to go to the sensitive points.
Okay, great.
On the crisis and make everything clear.
Great, thank you very much for coming.
Yeah, sure. Thank you so much. My pleasure.
You said refugees cannot go home or cannot be resettled. The UN is asking to come up with other forms of missions. So, for example, some private partnerships, like in Canada, there's some many civil society groups have decided to take in their home refugees.
For example, why don't you become a host family of this kind of host family to host the diverse, unique guests to your house? You can become one of the change makers also. There are thousands of global issues all over the world.
Maybe about Hafez al-Assad, when he came to the, when he ruled Syria, so in 1970, at the time he was defensive minister, at the time in the military, and he launched the coup, and which brought him to power. And after that he ruled Syria with iron fist, and he prevented the media, he arrested people for terrorism, or be killing, or ruined the world, and as people claim, and once you say you are Muslim, or sometimes in Japan, like I visit Okawai, or people get Islamophobia, and it's increasing around the world, so, because people don't investigate, or don't go deep in research, so this is the main source, or the main, like...
During breakout sessions, participants had a chance to talk and asked questions of the guests, and also suggested some proposals and ideas.
On Davos experience in Tokyo, and we talked about the refugees and human rights violations in Japan and elsewhere. And together with me is
Sayaka from LG.
And how did you like the session?
Today I share about our homestay program for refugees, and of course the homestay program itself is unique, but we need next step also to work together with refugee people. So on the table discussion I get many ideas how to integrate together and how to work together.
Okay. Your homestay program, is it well known to the Japanese, or what? How do they go about finding it if they want to do, if they want to host?
If you want to host, please visit the WLG homepage, mm-hmm. and there is a registration form for host family.
Yes.
And after registration, you have the interview with the WLG staff, and we will make the perfect match with your buddy and the homestay room.
I see. So that will be a very good start.
Yeah, it's starting.
It's something that we could do for the other refugees.
Yes.
Okay, great.
Thank you so much
for coming. Hi, we just finished the session number 49 of Davos Experience in Tokyo, and we had beer and pizza and all sorts of things, and we are very happy to introduce.
My name is Freddy. I'm from Congo DRC, Kinshasa in Africa.
Great, and you met with a new people today and you talked with them. How did you like the session?
Yeah, it was very nice. I get chance to meet a special one guest for the guy from Syria and also Japanese people. I hear what happened about the case of refugee from Syria and also in Japan.
Mm-hmm.
It was very interesting to know what happened and problem about it.
Right. What did you think of the Japanese people's knowledge? I think it was new to a lot of Japanese participants, isn't it?
So more Japanese people, they don't know about happen problem in foreign countries,
mm-hmm.
especially for refugees.
Right.
So I hope if they can discover that,
mm-hmm.
and then they can also give more advice and
right.
we can get some kind of good idea in the future.
I see. So I think that's what we could do.
Yeah.
And I do appreciate your coming to share your experiences.
So me too.
And
me
I
too.
Hope that you had a chance to talk with a lot of people.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
As I understand, knowledge is the first step to the action. So it was a very good and useful experience for all of us who were there. Thanks for coming.